Hi, good morning. So today is our next session for class 6. But our today's subject for SST will be civics. Okay, we have completed geography chapter 1. Now we will move to civics. And for civics, chapter 1 is Understanding Diversity. What is the chapter? Understanding Diversity. Please note down, our today's subject is Civics from SST, and chapter 1, the name of the chapter is Understanding Diversity. Written? Okay. Next, we will take the contents. Now, note down all the contents. What are we going to learn? And I am going to explain you in this chapter. Moving to the contents. Now, what are our goals for today? What are we going to learn? Now it is civics. So, you can ask say contents, or we can count it as what are our today's goal. What are we going to learn new? So, in this chapter, we will learn what is diversity. Okay, firstly we will see what is diversity. Then, what are the benefits of diversity? Whenever there is a diversity, you can say diversity, like you can say differences or changes. Okay, in easy words, you can say it as differences or changes, but in what ways? I'll explain you. Then we will see the benefits of these changes, benefits of these diversity, of this diversity. Okay, now diversity can be in any form. They can be historical and they can be geographical. So we will learn both of the diversities, historical also and geographical also. Now diversity has taken place everywhere. Everywhere means everywhere. We will see this diversity in India. What kind of changes the diversity has taken place in India, has brought in India. Okay, and after the changes, after this diversity, the unity in this diversity. Now when the diversity has taken place or the diversity is there, what the unity in this diversity, we will see that how people have accepted this and how is there a unity in this diversity. Okay, so we will move. First, let's have a short introduction about this chapter so that we will easily understand that what are we going to learn in this. Okay? Now, before moving to the chapter, a small introduction I had told you that in this chapter, you will learn that people are different from each other in many ways. We all know. All belong to different caste, all have different culture. Okay, not only do they look different, but they might also belong to different religious background, right? When we meet people, when we see people, we look that they all are different in different many ways, different in many ways. Okay. Now these differences enrich our life and also make them more fun, right? When we see something different, we try to know more about it and it becomes more interesting for us. You can say like it becomes more interesting for us to know about it, to live like them. All these different people who come from all kinds of background and belong to all kinds of religious and cultural help to make India so interesting and so diverse. Right? Why has India become a diversity? Why had we can say India is a diversity country? Like, because India is the only country where you can say all the religion live here together in unity. You can say differences, you can see differences in India by the way of living, how do the people live, by the way of culture, the eating habits of the people, the celebrating festivals that are also different. Okay, now we can say more that the diversity which we are talking about has two examples. The one is inequality and the other is caste system. This diversity we can count it in two examples. Inequality in what ways? Like we have seen people living in our society all are of not of the same position. Like some are rich and some are poor. Okay. So the poor people, they do not have enough to eat, to wear. Okay. And this is the inequality which comes after people, okay, they which do not have resources or opportunities. Now the people, the poor people, you know, they do not have that much opportunity to for the income, you can say, okay, they do not have the opportunities of income, good income, so that they could have all kind of facilities as the rich people have. And the second is the caste system. Okay. Now this caste system about which we are going to talk right now, this caste system is there because of the, we can say it is coming from the past. Okay. People in the society, we divide these people of in the society on the basis of the work they do. And we also see that the people are not supposed to change their professions. They are not supposed to change their professions. Means if their forefathers are doing a profession of, you can say, now if someone's father is a tailor. So it has been thought that the son of that person will also be the tailor. Means he has to take the profession what his forefathers are doing. Now this thinking has been coming from past. But now, no. Nowadays it's not like that. Okay, now there is a diversity. Here we have changed it. Now people want their children to be more qualified and study more and do what they want, become what they want. Is now if a father is a cobbler, he does not want his son to be a cobbler. He wants his son to be on a high profession, on a high designation. Right? So such kind of changes, what kind of changes are there? Like regional, cultural and religious backgrounds. All these things we are going to see in this chapter. Okay, now moving further, we will see about what is diversity, about which we are talking from since starting of the chapter. Now the main, what is diversity after the introduction. Diversity means having or belonging of different religion. You can say having, belonging to different religion, different culture, variety of food habits which we eat. In this you can count some people are vegetarian, some are non-vegetarians. So the food habits changed. Celebrating festivals that I told you. People celebrate festivals, but all the festivals are being celebrated in different ways. Languages, yes, of course. Language, the which we speak. All people speak different languages. Okay? And beliefs. You can say religious beliefs. All the people belong to different religions. And belonging to different religions, their beliefs are also different. Okay? Now here you can say that if a person follows a particular religion, and the another person may follow another religion. Different people speak different languages. Okay? But you may see many people speaking the same language as you do. Right? You may see many people. There may be the people coming in your life who may speak the same language which you do. But the difference, what will be the difference in that? The way of speaking, means the accent you can see. When you speak a language with someone, here we can take an example. Like in Rajasthan, we speak Marwari or Rajasthani language, right? But when a person comes from Gujarat or when a person comes from some other state like Maharashtra, Bihar or somewhere else, when he comes to Rajasthan, he can also speak Rajasthani, but the accent of his speaking of our language will be a bit different. So there in this country, or you can say in your life, you would meet people who would speak different languages with you. And of course, they can speak the same language which you do, but the accent will be different. So there can be too much of differences you can see in your life. It can be related with your language also, with the way of living also, festivals also, and eating habits also. Okay? Now moving further. Again, we will see the benefits. Now, the diversity which has come into our life. Now, what are the benefits of that diversity? What benefits have these changes brought in our life? Let's see. Now, people in the country, not only our country, okay? Now you can count this diversity in whole of the world. In whole of the world, the diversity takes place everywhere. The changes, you can say it is an easy word, the changes takes place everywhere. There are differences everywhere. The first difference which we see is the eating habit. Right? Now why to go far to the world? Let's take this diversity or this change of habit in our house only. Okay? Now the eating habits in the family are also different. How? Means you are liking something else. Your favorite dish will be something else and your father's favorite dish will be something else. So this is also one type of a diversity. Means the people have the eating habits different. And this shows the diversity. People show diversity in their eating habits. As we had talked about the diversity eating habits, diversity in eating habits, this is like vegetarian and non-vegetarian. So we can take it as example, like majority people of Gujarat are vegetarian. But as you move to a different state like Bihar, West Bengal or something like that, you will see people non-vegetarians. So these are the eating habits, and this also shows the diversity of people in eating habits. Okay? Now what are the benefits of these diversities? Is it good if there are such changes in our life, or there are such changes in our society? Then is it good? Yes, diversity gives many benefits in our life. Diversity adds varieties of way we live. variety to the way we live. How? We learn to understand and respect different types of culture. Now just think, if all the people in the country, if they would have taken only one religion and one culture, the interest of ours would have been over. We would have no interest. Why? Oh, everybody is celebrating the same way. What is the difference in that? We would say like that, right? But when there is difference in culture, difference in religion, difference in celebrating the festivals, we respect and try to understand that. Means as we are Hindus, we celebrate Holi, Diwali, Raksha Bandhan and many other festivals. But when we come to know about the Guru Parab, Eid, Muharram and all the things, we have that eagerness of knowing, na? We have the eagerness of knowing that, if we are celebrating Diwali by burning the crackers and lighting the diyas and all, then how is Muharram celebrated? How is Eid celebrated? We in Diwali or on our festivals, we prepare sweet dishes and different kinds of food items. Now, what do the people who celebrate Eid and Muharram and Guru Parab and all kinds of other festivals like Christians celebrate Christmas? So what are their culture? How do they celebrate that festival? So we try to understand, we try to respect, we try to know more about that culture. And this is because of the diversity. Diversity means differences. What are the different things going on? What different things are there? Cultures, religions. If this diversity was not there, we would have not understood or not respected any of the festivals. Okay? Now we learn to think from different angles. Whatever comes in our life, we try to know all this in different angles. Means we try to know more about it. Right? And had there been no diversity, it would have been a boring life. Means living only one culture, living only one type of life had made our life very boring. And because there is diversity, we are trying to know, we are trying to understand, we are trying to respect the different cultures that are there in our life. Okay? So diversity is mandatory, you can say. Diversity is compulsory. If diversity is not there, your life would have been a very boring life. Living a one type of life, living a one way of life, you would have never liked it. So diversity is compulsory. And because of this diversity, we are learning, we are respecting and understanding different types of culture. Right? Now, more is that, now what is the reasons? What are the reasons of this diversity? How are diversity caused? What is the reason of diversity? Let's see. The reason of diversity, you can count it in two ways. The one is the geographical reason, okay, which have geographical factors, and the other is the historical reason, or you can say the historical factors which diversity is influenced. Diversity is influenced by two factors. The one is geographical and second is historical. Here we will talk about the influence of geography on diversity. We will talk about the influence of geography on diversity. Now, geography means, you can say, whatever is around us, like our nature, climate, the way we wear the clothes and all. Okay? So, geography has a great influence of various aspects of our life. It is related, geography is related very nearly to our life. It influences the way we look, what is our personality, the food we eat, right? As we had, I had told you that the eating habits of each and every people is different. And the clothes we wear, the type of clothes we wear, everywhere there the wearing of clothes is different. From Rajasthan, if you move to Gujarat, the people, the wearing of clothes will become different. The system of wearing clothes will be different. Move further to Bihar, then you will see that it is, the wearing of clothes again will be different. So, India shows a great diversity. If you want to see different culture, the way of difference in living, way of eating foods, different habits of eating foods, then India is the best country that shows the great diversity. Okay? In terms of geographical features, the geographical features also are very different in all the states. Some states are very cold, some are very hot, some are humid. So this is also one type of diversity. But that is in a geographical factor. Okay? Now here we can take an example. Like you have heard the place Jammu and Kashmir. Okay? Now it is also a state. Now Jammu and Kashmir is the cold place. Because of its proximity to the Himalayas, people like to live there, right? Because it is cold place and it is a tourist place also, so people would like to go there in the summer season. If the Rajasthan, now it is summer, so we would like to go in some cool place, so we would select Jammu and Kashmir. Now if we talk about the people of Jammu and Kashmir, then they are fair skinned and they are generally tall. Okay, now talking about the clothes they wear. Now as we know, Jammu and Kashmir is a cold place. So the people living in that cold place will usually wear warm clothes. So automatically their complexion, or you can say their race, changes. They are fair skinned. Okay, they are tall, means here we are talking about the looks, okay, and the clothes they wear. Now because they are living in the cold place, they are, their way of living, their way of eating food, their way of wearing clothes changes, right? Now compare us with them. We live in Rajasthan, so can we wear warm clothes? No, because in summer we can't. Here it is a warm place. Rajasthan can be counted as hot place. Here the climate is hot. Only in winters we can get it cold climate. But Jammu and Kashmir is a cold place. That is cold, you can say, throughout the year. In summer also the temperature goes down very less. Not as much as in Rajasthan. Okay? Let's talk more about the influence of geography. After understanding about Rajasthan and Jammu and Kashmir, let's see some more states. Now, more further moving to the southern India. Now, southern India experiences, now that is totally a different climate in southern India. You can say in South India, the climate is hot and humid. Here we are seeing different examples, my dears. Different examples about the geographical features which has brought the diversity. Some examples of diversity which resulted because of the difference of geographical features. Okay, first we have seen about Jammu and Kashmir. Now we are moving to South India. Now Jammu and Kashmir, we had seen that the climate is cold. It is a cold place. Now as we move further or talk more further, now we are talking about Southern India, that is South India. In South India, the climate is totally different. Okay, now we experience hot and humid climate. The southern India experiences hot and humid climate. So now the majority of people in South India are dark skinned and usually of medium height. Now because of the difference in geographical factors, here again there is a diversity, again there is a change. The people we had seen in Jammu and Kashmir were fair skinned and tall. But now when we are talking about southern India, South India, the climate is hot and humid and the people are dark skinned and usually medium height. Now mostly, now looking at the clothes wearing. People in Jammu and Kashmir were wearing warm clothes because the climate was cold. Now if we see the people of Southern India, men in Southern India wear vesti, which is comfortable for the hot and humid climate. Here the eating habits also change. Because of the hot and humid climate, they have to change their eating habits to live as per the climate. So people eat lots of rice and coconut, which is used in most of the dishes. Okay, now if now here we talk, after talking about South India, if we talk about West Bengal, then the eating habit, clothes wearing habit, looks totally changes from Jammu and Kashmir to South India. People in West Bengal also experience the same climate as South India, that is hot and humid climate. But as West Bengal is in the eastern part of India, the people living in West Bengal are brown skinned, or sometimes you can say they are also dark skinned. So here the complexion, the race which we are talking about, changes again. Okay, and the eating habit of West Bengal again changes. The people of West Bengal eat rice and fish. So they are the non-veggies, we can say. Okay. So here, diversity, we are talking about diversity and we have seen what kind of diversities, what kind of changes are there in different states. The eating habits, the way of wearing clothes, okay, the looks. The one which you can say races. Okay. Fine. So now we will see more about diversity. Now let's talk more about diversity. Because our chapter is only understanding diversity. So here we are to understand about diversity. In what ways? India is the country of many diversities. We had talked about different states before this, right? Jammu and Kashmir, Rajasthan, West Bengal, South India, about Orissa and all. So India is a country of many diversities. If you want to see diversity, actual diversity, then India is the proper country where you would see different religions, different people. Okay, by names, religions, languages, habits, cultures, and other religious backgrounds. So what you have understand by diversity till now? Tell me that. Diversity means, first, speaking of language. In your life, you would get many people talk, many people, you will meet with many people, but you would also see that the people have the different way of talking. Their language would be different when you meet with them. The variety of food they eat. You would meet many people, but the food variety, the eating varieties, the eating habits of the people will be very different. Then the celebrating of festivals. the celebrating of festivals will be totally different. Okay? Now, if we think about diversity, we do many things that are similar with the people which we meet. Sometimes we feel, oh, this is the thing, I also do it. But the way of doing is totally different. Like celebrating festivals, if we take an example, oh, festivals, I also celebrate. But the way of celebrating that festival may be a total different. Right? So, here it is because of the diversity. Here it is because of the diversity that we see people talking different languages, eating different types of food, varieties of food, clothes wearing habits are totally different because of the diversity. Okay. After having the talk about the geographical factors on diversity, now let's see the historical factors. So now we have learned about civics, diversity, part 1. Okay, we have learned till the influence of geographical factors in diversity. We will continue this chapter in part 2 again. In that, we will discuss the historical factors of the diversity, word meanings from both the parts, question answers from both the parts, unity in diversity. Okay, so other topics we will continue in part 2. Till then, whatever you have studied till now from geography first chapter, from civics first chapter, please start studying and learning. Okay, now I'll meet you in the next section of part 2 of the same chapter, that is understanding diversity. Till then, take care of your health, study well, and goodbye.